Hello, dear all. So, in this presentation, we discuss the syphilitic stigma from Robert's philosophy. So, what is syphilitic stigma? It is the venereal stigmata. What is the meaning of stigma? It is the mark of disgrace. It is said that the patient afflicted with syphilitic taints suffers from structural changes. Yet, the emotional sphere in the purely syphilitic patient is not affected. Thus, the patient who has got the infection of syphilis, he suffers from various structural changes. In the primary syphilis, secondary syphilis, or tertiary syphilis stage. And in this case, his emotional sphere may not be affected. Syphilitic individual gets the ulceration and even the changes in the bony structure in the form of degeneration or deformity. Syphilis from its inception is a constitutional disturbance. Dr. Hahnemann said in the Organon of Medicine that syphilis is the chronic disease. So, syphilis is a constitutional disturbance. Syphilis is supposed to be contracted from an impure coition. So, syphilis as a disease is nothing but correlated with Hahnemann's miasm, syphilis. The syphilitic infection is a STD, that is sexually transmitted disease, from an impure coition. Much of the susceptibility and lowering of the defense towards the mental attitude of the individual, in that, in its very inception, it is violation of his moral standards, therefore reacts upon and lowers the vitality. So here, the immune system is affected, the resistance is lowered, and there is violation of his moral standards. So, violation of the emotional features of the patient. So, he reacts and there is a lowering of the resistance. Thus, impure coition takes place, and within 3 weeks after the exposure, when no symptoms or manifestations of any kind, the vital energy undertakes to expel this poison by forming chancre on some part of the body surface and usually genital organs. Vital energy is attempting to push the enemy outside of the body. Chancre remains on surface as an expression of inner turmoil. Thus, after the exposure, there is a formation of chancre usually on genital organs, and this formation of chancre is considered as vital energy is attempting to push the enemy outside the body, and chancre remains on the surface as an expression of this inner turmoil. This state may last for months or years, provided it is not suppressed. The general treatment among the physician is to cauterize or treat locally this manifestation. Such treatment tending to immediately dry the chancre and throw the poison back into the innermost system, and this treatment is very dangerous as there is the reversal of this energy which is throwing the chancre externally. So this energy goes back into the system and starts affecting various organs. The chain of symptoms then begins to develop. Vital energy is now profoundly disturbed. It is helpless to cope up this unaided enemy. So the individual is helpless to cope up this enemy. The next step taken by nature is to produce skin eruption on the body. If this manifestation is in turn treated by suppressive measures, the disease attacks internal organs, tending always to attack that part of organism which is least able to resist. Thus, the weaker organ will get affected. Any or all tissues of the body feels the deadening influence of this intruder. So, all the organs and tissues of the body are now aware of this intruder. Intruder means this new disease force. This manifestation may be suppressed in one place after another, so that man lives his life with this incubus in his system, ever ready to develop into new manifestations at the most trivial provocation. Thus, the removal of chancre causes the disease goes more deeper inside the vital organs. Again, if this disease is removed by the suppressive measures, it further metastasizes into another vital organ. Now, the causative factors which are provocating are grief, sorrow, and worry. Thus, this emotional turmoil will definitely have worsening effect on the organs pathology. Exposure to elements like a slight accident or the emotional stress of business, finance, relationship strain, or any one of many causes that starts the irritation, but unless this is met by the arts of similar anti-syphilitic remedy, he passes his days with discomfort and distress and comes to a premature old age. Such a classic representation of what happens one after the other, after the suppressive treatments. So this suppressive treatments, along with the newer stresses of life, the patient is in the misery and he will pass into the various discomfort and distresses and comes to a premature old age. And this will continue unless he is treated by the similar anti-syphilitic remedy. This stigmata has its effects upon protozoan, and the offspring shows the effects in many ways. When offspring is affected with the syphilitic taint, he will not show direct effect in the primary chancre or ulcer, for by the time the disease has passed into the second generation, it becomes the part of his living. This results in many constitutional tendencies and deformities. Thus, the mother who is carrying this syphilitic taint will pass to the child, and this child will not develop the primary chancre, but it will be in the other ways affecting various organs in the form of degeneration and deformities. Chronic catarrhal condition of the nose and throat is usual form. Malformations of teeth or crowding of teeth is usual feature. Ulcers and many other manifestations are seen. So, we already saw the deformities and degeneration is the very common feature of syphilitic miasm. Manifestations have changed their character. Now, the economy is thoroughly impregnated with the deadening and destructive effects of this stigma. Union of psora and syphilis. The psoric symptoms predominate, and here the predominant symptoms of psora must be treated first with the antipsoric simulimum. For the syphilis is largely hidden, we must strive to help the vital force to throw off the greater and more predominant incubus which the patient manifests. Thus, the union of psora and syphilis, if the psoric symptoms are predominating in the patient, then we treat the patient first with antipsoric remedy. And if the syphilis is hidden, then at the next step is to give the prominent antisyphilitic remedy. After the patient responds to the remedy by a decided improvement in the condition first prescribed for, and the psoric condition is now largely obliterated, when it is removed, we must change our tactics, that is our strategy, for then the syphilitic dyscrasia will show itself and become predominant. It means that the administration of the antipsoric remedy not only removes the psoric conditions, the psoric symptoms, but the hidden syphilitic dyscrasia comes upwards and becomes prominent, and thus this helps in the administration of the antisyphilitic remedy. Then the symptoms must be met with the antisyphilitic simulimum or the remedy that is most similar and adopted to syphilitic symptoms, to which we will be guided by the similitude of the remedy. The patient who is suffering from syphilis in latent state or who manifests the inherited stigma presents a picture that is very easy to recognize, and this is probably the easiest of the miasms or stigma or threat. So the symptoms are of now of syphilitic miasm helps in the administration of antisyphilitic remedy. Patient with inherited or latent syphilis are mentally dull, heavy, stupid, stubborn, sullen, morose, and suspicious. They are always depressed, with premature old-looking face. They develop fixed ideas which are not eradicated by any amount of explanation or talk. So the delusions are the feature of syphilitic miasm. That means the fixed ideas. So suspiciousness, then the stupidity, the dullness is a feature of syphilitic miasm. Mental powers are slow in reaction. They like to be alone, yet desire to escape from themselves and from others. Thus, it means that in the individual, we may not get the history of syphilitic infection now. It may be present in the previous generations. And the current individual patient now presents directly with this type of emotional mental state or the pathology in the form of degeneration, deformities. Forget what they were about to say, and they find it hard to get back into the track of their conversation. Worse at night, all the symptoms develop more after the sun goes down. And this is exactly opposite of the psora miasm, where psoric patients are aggravated during day and syphilitic patients are aggravated at night. Operation, restlessness and anxiety at night is a very important feature of syphilitic miasm. appearance of external manifestations or unusual discharges. Means like example, otitis media or ulcerative discharges. We will observe that patient is greatly improved in general and his mental state will seemingly become more normal. Thus, the return of these discharges, abnormal in type, gives relief to the patient. Sweating aggravates rather than ameliorates. So, amelioration sweating is in the psoric miasm. Sweat is a natural elimination. So, in syphilitic miasm, natural elimination like sweat, urination, diarrhea never ameliorates, but in psoric state they ameliorate. So syphilitic conditions you get, patient is relieved with the abnormal discharges. Tubercular miasm is a combination of syphilitic and psoric miasm. Hereditary syphilitic troubles in children sometimes produce a very watery discharge that almost completely drains the system of its vital fluids, and unless promptly corrected, death ensues. So this is the experience Dr. Robert has narrated. The gangrene of the skin and dry gangrene shows the destructiveness of the syphilitic stigma. Syphilis is only miasm or stigma that actually destroys living tissue. So, it is the most destructive miasm, and the usually we see gangrene, ulcer of the skin which never heals. We see radioactivity and disintegrations are common thought, and this applies equally to the syphilitic stigma. Disintegration meaning the process of losing cohesion or strength. Radioactivity is the property of emitting energy and subatomic particles spontaneously. So, we frequently find a patient susceptible to natremur, so in potentiated form, but who has partaken repeatedly and frequently of salt in the diet with no appreciable vital effect. So, this patient will be only relieved by potentized form of natremur. Yet in continued attack by force and motion upon the construction of sodium atom, these energies have been released in the process of potentiation so that the substance is changed in its very essentials and it takes on and retains as artificial radioactivity, which activates it for a considerable period of time. Thus, Dr. Robert has tried to correlate this. So, the sodium atom undergoes the attack of force and motion during the process of potentization. And this is related with the artificial radioactivity, which reactivates it for a considerable period of time. Thus, the common salt is not having the medicinal effect, but the sodium atom, after it undergoes the process of potentization, this will be acting as a curative as its latent powers are liberated. And that was the discussion on syphilitic stigma from Robert's philosophy. Thank you.